Hey folks, my name's Josh, and we're gonna spend a few minutes here talking about private internet access. This particular time is gonna be broken into three different parts. First, we have the review. Second, we're gonna do a walkthrough of a computer setup. And third, we're gonna do a walkthrough of the mobile setup so that you can know exactly what you're getting into. You can jump to any of those using the time markers you see right here. For now, let's go ahead and jump into our review. All right. First of all, if you're the kind of person who knows they need a secure VPN but doesn't care to understand the nuances of encryption, OpenVPN, DNS, and so on, private internet access is probably going to appeal to you. Of the numerous VPNs that I've tested, private internet access is by far the most simple that I've run across. It's also one of the cheapest. Their downloadable application is a great example of this simplicity. Check it out. Other than your username and password, there really aren't many options you have to worry about. There are a few extra settings I can play with when I click the connection button at the bottom. It's a button that gives me access to options like a VPN kill switch, port forwarding, connection type, etc. But for most of you, this will never be something you deal with. I also have the option to play with encryption settings, which again, I don't suggest you do unless you know what you're doing. My main point though is that in default mode, the private internet access application is incredibly simple even if you've never dealt with a VPN before. Just log in, click on the icon located in the upper right-hand corner for Mac users, usually on the lower right-hand corner for Windows users, and then choose your gateway. That's it. Okay, now for my pros and cons list. Let's start with what I really like about private internet access. First of all, as you'll see in the setup tutorial coming up next, the installation process is unbelievably simple and fast. It took me less than 5 minutes to get up and running. Second, they allow up to 5 simultaneous device connections, which is a lot when you consider that most VPN services usually only allow 2 at a time. Third, Private Internet Access is a US-based company, which means they have no requirements to log user IP and activity, which for those of you who don't know, is a good thing because it keeps your activity completely anonymous. You can use pretty much every major credit card as well as PayPal to sign up, but for those who want even more anonymity, they give you the option to pay with Bitcoin. Or for those of you less tech savvy, you can go out and buy a gift card for Starbucks and pay with that. Seriously, I've never seen that before, but it's pretty cool. Finally, this is something that most reviews of private internet access get wrong. This company offers a 7-day refund. They don't publicize this offer, but it is honored. Just email them if you're not satisfied, and they'll give you a refund within 7 days. And that's what I like about private internet access. Here's what I was less impressed by. First, there are no native mobile apps, either for iOS or Android. What this means for you is that setup on a mobile device is manual, and as you're going to see in my setup tutorial, a bit difficult. While other VPN services offer a simple download setup, this was pretty much unnecessarily hard. Second, while they do offer 10 different countries, for the most part, you don't have the option to connect to specific servers. I feel like their target audience probably doesn't care about that, but it's something worth noting. Finally, while simplicity is a great thing, I did miss some of the options, bells and whistles I've come used to with other VPNs. For instance, I wish there was more than just one plan available. I wish I could see my upload download speeds. I wish I had a few more settings options. You know, these are all minor complaints though. Overall, you really can't beat the value that private internet access provides, especially if your primary goal is to get connected to a VPN as quickly as possible. Use the button you see here to check out their pricing and other details that I don't have time to cover here, and then use the remainder of this video to see how to set up private internet access on your computer and your mobile device. Okay, we're here now on the computer setup part of private internet access. You can see that I'm on their homepage. I just clicked the Get Start Now button, and I'm going to scroll down. This is all in real time, so you can realize just how fast this is. I'm going to use their monthly plan. Click on the Buy Now, and then I want to use my PayPal account. Even though they do offer Bitcoin, a lot of different options for you. For me, the easiest thing is just going to be to use my PayPal account. Quick and simple. I did mention before they do allow you to use gift cards, which I thought is really interesting. They make it very simple. You can use anything from Walmart to Starbucks, but like I said, I'm going to use PayPal. I'm getting here to the confirmation screen where I'm going to click agree and pay. And at this point, they're going to redirect me back to one of their pages. And I'm going to move back over here to my email account. As you can see here, I've already received a couple different emails from PayPal, as well as 3 emails from Private Internet Access, including their installer links. So I'm using OS X. I'm going to click on their OS X installer. And whether you're using OS X or if you're using Windows, you can click on those particular installer buttons and it's going to install here, as you can see happening at this moment. It's a pretty relatively small file, but once it finishes downloading, I'm just going to click to have it open up and then I'm going to unpack it. I'm going to install it here on my Mac. I've double-clicked here, but you can see that it's not opening because it says it's from an unidentified developer. If this happens to you, don't worry. Just click OK, right-click on the file, and click Open. That basically just tells your Mac that you know you want to open this particular file, and from Private Internet Access, you can be assured that it's going to be an OK file. So I've downloaded it here, and I was actually surprised to find that my username and password was already input into it, so I wanted to double check to make sure that it was actually my username and password. It is, which is really cool. That means you don't even have to worry about anything. Once you install it, you just click on the save button, and once you've clicked on the save button, I'm going to go up into, for me in the Mac, the upper right hand corner of the window. For Windows users, it's going to be the bottom right, and then I will connect to the server location that I want to be on, and it's that simple. All right, and now welcome to the iOS setup portion of this tutorial. I'm going to go back into my email where they sent me all my login information. This is going to be important because the first thing I have to do whenever I'm going to be setting up any sort of mobile device with private internet access is to log in to my client control panel using the information that they sent me in my email, and then I need to go down to the bottom here. You're going to see where they say that you need to generate or regenerate a username or password. So I'm going to generate one right here. Now, I'm going to go ahead and show you everything I see because I've already regenerated, and what you see here wouldn't work if you tried it on your own. But I've got to take and write down my username and password, and then I'm going to go back into the settings file of my iPad. I'm using my iPad here. Click on the VPN and then add a VPN configuration. For private internet access, I'm going to use the L2TP, and in the description, I'm going to type in private internet access. You can actually put in anything you want. This is really just for you to know. And then in the server field, I'm going to put in, I'm in China right now, so I'm going to put in the closest server that I can, which is in California. So I'm going to do us-california.privateinternetaccess.com. For the account, I'm going to put in exactly what they told me to put in when I generated that password. It's always going to start with an X. It's not going to start with a P. So mine is the X1372249. And then they gave me a password, which I have to put in. You see the RSA secure ID. Make sure that that is off. And then in the secret field that you see right below this, I'm going to put in my safety. No spaces, no capital letters. This is something that everybody's going to do the same of. I'm going to make sure that send all traffic is good and go ahead and do that. Click on private internet access and turn it on. Now, for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and tell you that I did have some problems. The server did not respond here. And so what I had to do is I had to go into their website and use their online support. And so I went in there and let them know that I was having some problems. And the good news is that they responded immediately. I could go on here. I could have sent in a support ticket, but here they were able to respond to me almost immediately. They did respond with canned responses, and I had to kind of configure what I wanted to understand. But basically what it came down to is I had to go into my network utility, and I had to go actually look up the numerical address for my US-California. Hopefully this isn't something you have to do, but if you have the same problem I do, I just wanted to show you what I had to do. So I'm looking this up, and you see the numerical, the 50.23. I wrote that down, and I'm going to go back in to change the US-California to the numerical IP address. So once I put that in, I'm going to save it and turn on my VPN for the iPad. And you're going to notice once it connects, there's going to be something in the upper left-hand corner that says VPN, and I am good to go. It's that simple. Again, thanks so much for watching, and if this review is helpful, give it a thumbs up, or you can use the button here to access the Private Internet Access website. Thanks so much.